I couldn't do it. I had to walk away, you know? I had to get out of that situation because I don't do that anymore, you know? The last time I got in a real, like, knockdown, drag-out fist fight was 2008, and I was wearing the bottom half of a Cookie Monster costume. As you do, you know? In fairness to me, it was Halloween. It was Brooklyn, 2008, and I had made my own costume. I was very proud of it. It was blue fur. There was a bottom half and a top half, ping pong balls for the eyes, you know. I was so proud of it. It wasn't like a sexy Cookie Monster costume. Well, it depends on what you're into, but. I don't normally do the slutty Halloween costume thing because I figure, hey, 364 days out of the year, I'm slutting it up. This is costume night. So I don't normally do that. Also, I do feel that this slutty Halloween costume is it creative, you know? It's never like a sexy, hot ATM machine or something. It's always just like a set of bunny ears and some lingerie. And you're like, what are you? And the girl's like, I'm a sexy bunny. And you're like, not too a bunny. So I was having a great time. My costume was raging all night long. And then 4 a.m. rolled around. We decided to go home. And there was no cars. No cabs came to Brooklyn in 2008. There was no Uber or anything like that. So we just had to wait for the bus. And during that wait, I did have to pee. So I was like, I know what to do. Just went over to the curb and popped a squat. Took off the top half a cookie. No problem. And I'm squatting. And I'm peeing and having a great time. You know, pee is for pee-pee. It's good enough for pee. It's mind of my business, you know? And then a car pulled up to the intersection. Totally empty streets, a car pulls up. Like, I remember it like it was yesterday. It was a vintage station wagon, just pristine condition, full of, I'm gonna say, Urban Outfitters models. Who were dressed up like so sexily. They had like skin tight leather costumes and glitter makeup. They were like a glam rock band or something, you know, like the Runaways or whatever. Plus it was freezing and they were in a car, so I was already angry. And I looked in the window at them and I could see that they were pointing at me and laughing at me. And I was like, okay, I know what to do. So I just hiked up, bottom half a cookie, go out into the intersection, and I knocked on the driver's side window. And she rolls it down, and I was like, hey, were you guys just laughing at me? And she was like, yeah. And I was like, oh, cool, just because, and then I punched her in the face. So the driver of that car just got hit by a pedestrian, is what has happened. They drove off. I turned around to my boyfriend. I was like, I'm the king of New York. He was like, no, you're not. You're a bad person. I was like, I had to do something. They was laughing at me. He was like, yeah, you were peeing in the gutter wearing the bottom half of Cookie Monster. Everybody was laughing at you. You're a disgrace. I was like, I'm not a disgrace, you're a disgrace. Felt great about myself. And then I felt another sensation, a smack on the back of my head because the Runaways had parked and come back for me. And my boyfriend was not gonna help. The bus had not arrived. So then I was just in an all-out street brawl with all four members of the Runaways wearing blue fur from here down. I look like a Jim Henson centaur. Just like duking it out. I woke up the next morning more ashamed than I've ever been in my entire life. Not just because, you know, I had just like been an idiot and had bruises all over my face and blue fur where it shouldn't be. I think the reason I was so ashamed was because I had disgraced the costume. I mean, we all know it. Cookie Monster is an inspiration. You know, he does not have an easy life, that monster. I mean, he lives for one thing and one thing only, right? He lives for the cookie. All he thinks about all day long are cookies. All he wants to do is hang out with kids, draw pictures of cookies, sing about cookies. He fucking named himself after a cookie. And yet, every single time he goes to take a bite out of a delicious cookie, he puts it up to his mouth, and then he just goes fucking nuts and it crumbles to pieces and falls out. I mean, his life is hell. He doesn't punch anybody about it. He doesn't complain. He's never even gone to see a doctor about his esophageal issues. It has been 70 years. He has never ingested an ounce of cookie. I mean, at a certain point, he's choosing to be a victim. But that's the face of addiction, you know? And that's when I decided, then and there, that I was gonna get sober 9 years later. So I did it. I went for it.